don't know about you, but I've been doing a lot more work with people who are nowhere near me. In fact, just last year, I edited a feature film with both an assistant editor and director, and none of us shared a space. It's becoming way more plausible to work with people remotely. And new updates to both Final Cut Pro 10 and Frame.io are going to make that even easier. But before we dive into that, let's talk about the brand new features inside of Final Cut 10.4.9 and Frame.io 3.7. First in Final Cut Pro 10, we finally have camera settings for ProRes RAW media from supported cameras and devices. You can now make changes to your exposure offset, ISO, and color temperature all within the inspector in Final Cut. For those of you creating non-landscape media, Smart Conform will analyze your shots and auto-crop them to fit into square, vertical, or custom shapes. This is especially helpful whenever you're creating digital signage, event media, or even social media. To make this even easier, there's a new Transform Overscan feature, which will allow you to see any footage that falls outside of your viewer. That way you can reposition anything that's been conformed and make sure that you've got exactly what you want within frame. My personal favorite hidden gem feature within Final Cut Pro 10 is the brand new one-step audio crossfade. Finally, I can hit one key and it will extend the audio on both sides of an edit and create a fade. Frame.io 3.7 is also chock full of new features, the first of which is HDR for iPhone and iOS. This does only work on the latest iPhone and iPad devices like the iPad Pro and the iPhone 11, but it is absolutely worth it. And if you're wanting to watch on a big screen TV, you can AirPlay from your iPhone or iPad to an Apple TV connected device. Frame.io 3.7 also introduces updates to Watermark ID, our session-based watermarking tool that enables you to embed the name, email address, and IP address of the person watching the video. This really helps deter piracy. 3.7 also introduces Frame.io transfer, which is the absolute best way to upload and download massive amounts of footage from Frame.io. Finally, we're introducing a major update to our workflow extension inside of Final Cut Pro 10. Between the updates in Final Cut and in Frame.io, there are all new ways to work with proxy media. This is going to be huge for any of you who are working from home or on the road. There are a few different reasons you might want to work with proxy media. First, maybe you're working with 8K raw footage, which, let's be honest, has plenty of performance overhead, especially on a laptop. Secondly, proxies are significantly more portable. I can't count the number of times that an editor asked me if I could move 10 terabytes of footage onto an external hard drive so that they could edit from home. While moving 10 terabytes is pretty difficult to do in a short amount of time, proxies, because they're smaller, are very easy to move onto an external drive. In previous versions of Final Cut, you only had two different playback modes. One was original, the other was proxy. If you couldn't playback in original, you played in proxy. The caveat with proxy is that you had to generate a proxy file for every single file if you wanted to work in proxy mode. That meant if you were working with a mix of 8K footage and iPhone footage, you still had to wait for all of the iPhone footage to have proxies just to be able to see the 8K footage. That was not super helpful. Thankfully, Final Cut has a new mode called Proxy Preferred. Proxy Preferred will play back either original or proxy. That means now you can, in fact, just create proxies for your 8K footage, and it will play back as proxy, and anything that you don't create a proxy for will play back as original. This is super helpful for anyone working with mixed media. Final Cut 10.4.9 introduces a few new ways that you can generate proxies inside of Final Cut. Previously, you could only generate ProRes proxy files at about a quarter of the resolution. Now you can generate either ProRes proxy or H.264 files at 12.5%, 25%, 50%, or same as source. Or if you prefer to choose a specific resolution, you can go with 540, 1080, or 4K. In addition to generating proxies inside of Final Cut Pro 10, you can now import them from other sources. For example, in the Frame.io workflow extension, you used to only be able to import proxies as originals. But now, if you import both originals and proxies, Frame.io will import the originals as originals and proxies as proxies. If you want to change those settings, you can choose to download the original media, highest resolution proxy, or the lowest resolution proxy in your import settings. In addition to importing proxies from a workflow extension, you can also relink to proxies that were created outside of Final Cut. For example, you can download entire folders full of original and proxy media using Frameio transfer. Once you import the original footage, you can then relink to the proxies that Frameio generated. Relinking also comes in super handy if you're working with dailies generated by a film lab, if the camera you're working with records both RAW and proxy internally, or in the case that you like to set up render farms using Apple Compressor. Now that we know how to get proxies into Final Cut Pro 10, let's talk about some things that we can do with them. You'll remember earlier, I was talking about an editor who wanted to bring 10 terabytes worth of footage home with them. Well, that 10 terabytes is pretty hefty. But the proxies for that 10 terabytes are actually significantly more portable. To work with them, we'll want to create what's called a proxy library. To do this, right-click on the original library and select Copy to Library, New Library. You'll then be given new media management options. First, make sure that you select proxy media and deselect both original media and optimized media. You may be worried about your stills and audio, but rest assured, they will come along as well. Next, make sure that your media destination is set to a folder on the external drive that you want to send home with the editor. If you have any external media, make sure to enable copying media stored in external locations so the editor doesn't accidentally walk away without anything that they need. If there's any media that doesn't currently have a proxy representation, Final Cut will take the opportunity to generate those proxies for you. While these new media management tools are extremely useful for creating proxy libraries, they're also useful for moving events, clips, and projects between libraries. Overall, the new media management toolset in Final Cut 10.4.9 is extremely flexible. Between the new toolset in Frame.io and Final Cut Pro 10, you now can work wherever you want, with whomever you want, all without sacrificing performance. So what about you? How will you use the new tools in Final Cut 10.4.9 and Frameio 3.7? Let us know in the comments below. The person with the most unique answer will win 3 months of Frameio Enterprise with Watermark ID. So keep those comments coming. Thanks for watching and stay creative.